All this took place at the cross of voices response to God. Oh, that today you would hear his voice, pardon not the thoughts that know, as in the day of Moses in the desert, where your forebears tempted me, they tested me, but they have seen my works. Now, before we are tempted to judge the fickle Israel of us, watching the lack of memory, God's goodness, and the lack of faith and trust in God, despite all that God has done for them, just think of how we might do the same in our own lives today. We too are acknowledging our lives as well for people who live their own lives, not to part with all of us, as we are spending time today to become sort of fallen prayers. If today we hear God's voice, pardon not your hearts. Not too long ago, I was talking here, I mentioned that one of the most important words in the Latin liturgy is the Latin word "Now," today. All the promises and all the warnings of scriptures are present in our lives now today. We need to forget the gratitude to God every good gift is so readily available. It's even in the midst of COVID-19, all that has affected the lockdown rights, disease, and the restrictions that has placed on us. Even in the midst of the failure from our governments, the dysfunction of the Congress, the violence we have witnessed from domestic terrorism in our nation, and the threat to peace in our world. Yes, even in this, God is with us. How many burning bushes are you next week? Billions of clouds and fire, none of them in heaven, must be experienced before we believe that God will deliver us from whatever we are facing. While we easily forget to thank God for the manna that every day sends our way to nourish and strengthen us. God has demonstrated God's love for the people of Israel by using Moses to lead them out of Egypt to the promised land. But in today's first reading, Moses tells them that he is not the last prophet. The Lord said to me, said Moses, I will raise up a prophet like you from among your people, and will put my words into his mouth, and he shall tell them all that I have done. These words, Moses gave their warning to the people. Listen to this new prophet that is rising up among you. Prophet whom God has sent to save and deliver God's people and all of us from our bondage to sin and defeat. The Lord Jesus Christ. In today's gospel, Jesus comes to the problem. And without the exceeding formal training, he begins to be with a heart in the synagogue. All of our names and national and other words of this, a new teaching of the Father, he commands even unclean spirits to be obeyed. People were astonished when Jesus healed the demoniac. Soon his fame extended throughout all Galilee, and people began to recognize that Jesus as the one. And all the old prophets, including Moses, were told. No rest for today. The Lord speaks to us, pulling out of the darkness of sin's history. He is the light that starts guiding us from our own personal existence. So if today you hear God's voice, pardon not your hearts. Watch and wonder as Jesus demonstrates God's love for us, and humble wisdom. Listen, as we heard at Jesus' baptism from the voice of heaven, this is my beloved Son. Listen to him, but listen well, that we may do what we are called to do. And when you experience